Today, we're going to be creating this pipe flange that you happen to see on the screen. Now, even if you're not creating a pipe flange for your project, we're also going to be learning some skills and techniques that you can use for whatever you're working on. So in this case here, we're going to do a revolve, we're going to do a pattern, we're going to add some chamfers and some fillets, and so on, and plus a whole bunch of other skills and techniques that you can translate or use for anything you're working on. So to get started, let's go ahead and just take a look at what went into creating this flange. So right over here, I'm going to click on the items, and it's going to come over here to sketch one. You can see right over here, I've got a bunch of dimensions defining what that shape is. Then we take that and we revolve that around to create this body, right? Then once we've got that body, I'm going to go ahead and create another sketch on the top of that, which is going to define where all these different holes are. Then we're going to cut those holes right through the flange and then come back and add some fillets and chamfers. If you look over here on the history bar, you can see here, I've got my sketch one over here. There's that revolve. Sketch of where the holes are. We're going to extrude those through, fillet up here, another fillet over here, and then finally a chamfer for all the top and bottom of those holes. So that's basically what we're going to be doing in this project. So let's go ahead and take a look at the dimensions for this flange. Now this is a standard pipe flange. Dimensions are available multiple different places, but I happen to have made a little cheat sheet for us. So we can go ahead and look at this slideshow here. So that's what the flange is going to look like. And here is the dimensions of what the flange is going to be. And right over here, you can see that's the dimension of where the holes. So we're going to start here and define what these dimensions are and create a sketch that looks a lot like what you see here on the screen. Let's switch back over here to Shaper. And let's go ahead and start a brand new project. All right, so right over here, I'm going to get rid of these and just put them away on the sides. I want to start drawing something right from the beginning. So I'm going to start a sketch. So here's my sketch, and I'm going to choose one of these surfaces. I'm going to choose this one here, that first plane, and I want to start with a center line. So I'm going to start with a line. I'm going to go directly up. The length really doesn't matter right now, and I'm going to hit escape. Then I'm going to go back to that line. I'm going to say, hey, no, sorry. Click on that line itself. Here it is. And I want to say this is a construction line. That's what I want to revolve everything around. Okay. Then come back, hit the L on the keyboard. So I'm clicking and creating yet another line. I'm going to create this line out here. And this is going to define the inside of our shape. Now, the ID of this thing is going to be 8.72. Right. So I'm going to click here first and then hit escape. Actually, if you happen to have just clicked out of here, you can just click back on that line. That's going to show back up. And then I can just double click on this and have the input here. So the diameter is going to be 8.72. So I'm going to say 8.72. But I happen to be working in the radius. So I'm going to say divide that by 2 and then click OK. And then I've defined that length right there. Now, of course, I want this not to be a regular line. I want that to be construction geometry again. So that's defining what the inside is. Go back over here to the line command. Come up here. I'm going to define the height. Now notice because I'm going vertical here, the dimension or the length is changing. I can just right here. I can just type that in. So it's 1.75. Right. Hit enter there. Now notice that just shows up though it's stuck to my cursor and spinning around. And I want to make sure that that's actually locking to the kind of the vertical. So click over here and lock it to the vertical. Now I want to head over this direction. In this case, I'm going to not type in the dimensions. I'm going to click here. I'm going to click here. I'm going to click out here. You know, back over to here. Drop it down one, and then back over here to the origin. Okay. Now notice this little angle here. I made a mistake, and it came in at an angle. That's okay. I can fix that. So if I click on that one, I can say, hey, I'd like this to be horizontal. And that automatically fixes that, which makes it handy. And notice over here, this also wants to be horizontal. So click on that. And that's going to define where all those things are. Now what we want to do is we want to go back and start adding in some dimensions. So I'm going to choose something from like the center line and come out here to this point here. So I'm going to hold down shift, pick that point right there, and then define what that's going to be. Now that happens to be 5.31. I'm just going to pull that information from my drawing there. So I'm going to type it in, 5.31. Okay. The overall size from this line here, shift out here to one of these. Again, this dimension here. So that wants to be 13.5 as a diameter, which happens to be 6.75 as a radius. So 6.75 is my radius, defines that. This spacing from here in, I'm going to go ahead and just move that over. I can see a little closer. So I'm going to say from this line here. So I can say from that point there, hold on shift to that point right there. or actually we actually go from that line to that point there, and right there, that dimension here. Again, double click on it, 0.06. Okay, and now we're just kind of going around our shape and defining the things that we know. Something like this, just making sure it's always a good idea to kind of make it a horizontal or vertical. So you're defining and just locking all those things in. How about the height of this? So from there down to here, so I can just shift and select something like that. And that's already the 1.75 here. And then this is the 1.2, which is not actually the right value. We need it 1.12. So I'm going to click here and say 1.12. It's defining that. Now from my other dimension, I actually know the dimension from this point here over here to the center point. So if I click on there, I can define these. I just kind of like to space these out so I can see them a little bit clearer. And this dimension happens to be 4.845. So 4.845. Okay. And there that is. Now, of course, this got messed up a little bit. That's okay. I can just drag that back over here. And that looks fine. And the thing we have in the drawing is an angle here. So I'm going to choose this line here. Hold on shift. That line right there. And I'm going to define that angle. So it has to be 7 degrees from the vertical, or in this case, 97 degrees. Okay, and now that's all looking pretty good, right? So in this point, you might want to just click and try to drag something around. And so notice right here, it's like I'm dragging it around. There's a problem. Like, why is this happening, right? Well, it's because we forgot to lock this point to the origin. So click on that, lock it to the origin. Now if I grab something and try to move it around, well, something still didn't work here. So hold on. Let's grab that point. Let's drag it over here to the origin and then say lock. Okay, and just make sure that that is locked. And now it should be locked in and we should be good to go. Okay, so now I have my shape. Now I have my axis of rotation. The next thing I want to do is start doing a rotation, right? So right over here, I can go over here to tools and I want to go down here to revolve. Click on revolve and it says, what do I want to revolve? Well, I want to revolve that shape, right? And I want to revolve it around that line. And as soon as I do that, notice what happens. It just gives me the revolve exactly what I'm expecting, right? So here's my revolve, looking pretty good. Click on done, and there's my first revolve. Pretty handy. Okay, now what I want to do is I want to go to that top surface here, and I want to start a new sketch. So click on sketch, and I want to put a circle. I want to put it right over here. But before I do that, I'm going to start with the line command, snap to the center of this thing, and define the value, right? So the value I'm looking for here is whatever that bolt hole circle happens to be. So in this case, the bolt hole circle happens to be 11.75. And I can actually type it in here, 11.75. But we're working on, I got one too many. Let's go all the way back. 11.75. And then I'm gonna say, I wanna divide that by 2 because I'm working with just the radius. Click OK, and that's gonna define where things are. Now, that line right there, I also want that to be construction. So I'm changing over to construction, and then I'm going to go ahead and choose C for circle and draw a circle right over here. The circle I want happens to be 0.88. Hit enter, and there is my circle. Pretty nice. Okay, now once I have that, I can then use this to do something else, right? I can create a 3D shape. I can use that to cut into my design. So here's my shape. If I spin my model around here, I can say, hey, I'd like to use that shape, and I want to just push that right through the model, right? So here's my, I can just push it right through, no problem, right? Once I have that, hit escape, or hit enter, actually. And then now I've got a hole, right? And I really want to have more than one hole, right? But there's my first hole. Now I can define, if I want to go all the way through it, I can define the depth and things like that. And you can look over here under history and say, hey, that extrusion, how am I defining that? My distance, I'm going to type something in. I could also say, hey, up to an object, that'd be okay. And then select the object. I could say, well, yeah, I'd like to use just probably the bottom of the part, right? That's okay. Click okay. And that's probably a little bit better defined right now. It's just going to go up to that next surface, right? And notice I've got the one profile selected. Well, what if I wanted to have multiple holes, right? I don't want to go ahead and create and do that each time. That's a lot of extra work. So I want to use some type of a pattern feature, right? So in this case here, if I go back to that sketch, right? If I go take a look at this thing here, not that, let's go that. Okay, over here are our items, right? Here's my sketch. So if I go ahead and take a look at that sketch, I can actually use some of the patterning tools here. So here's our pattern tools. And I can find, hey, where do I want to rotate this around? I'm going to put that right at the center. And I'm going to say, well, I like to kind of pattern this little hole around this profile here. So instead of three, I actually probably want this to go through 360 degrees, right? So we're going all the way around, and forward or backwards doesn't really matter. And then over here, as far as the mount, I'm going to type in 8, and there's my 8, and that's looking pretty good. Okay, so that is my updated pattern. Now, what's cool about the history bar over here, notice we've only got that one hole. There's my hole, but now I've added to that original sketch a bunch of other holes. So if I go over here back to that extrusion, if I twirl it down, notice it's got one face or one for profile. I'm going to go ahead and click on edit, and I'm going to say, hey, I'd like to add a few more. So I'm going to go and add these to the group, and notice as soon as I click on the individual profiles, right, it's automatically turning those into holes as well, right? So you can go back and modify those sketches so that you are able to, you know, create and expand the features beyond where they were originally, okay? So right over here, things are looking pretty solid, pretty good. Next couple things we need to do are we're gonna go ahead, and I'm gonna hide that sketch over here, so we're only looking at the shape itself. Now we need a few radiuses and fillets. So let's go ahead and start right here. So if I hit F on my keyboard, it turns on the fillet or chamfer tool. And if I choose this edge right here, I can then drag this in or out to kind of take a look at what it's going to be. I want 0.252 for this in this case, right? So there's my 252. Looks pretty good. Click on the green or that blue check mark or check box or done. And how about a couple more fillets, right? So this time, like, try it again. And I'm going to choose like this edge right there. And this time I know from my drawing that I'd like a radius of 0.076, right? So it's added that and click on that. Looks okay. But hey, actually, I did notice that I want to fill it more than just that edge, right? I want to go back and change it. So right over here is that fillet. So again, I can go down here. I can say, hey, instead of one edge, I can go in and edit it. I want to say, hey, the inside, how about that one down there? The outside edge, I can hold down shift, rotate my model around. I can pick this edge right here. How about this edge inside here? All those, click OK, and now I've added all those fillets back to that same feature, right? So pretty nice and easy way to do that. Now how about a chamfer, right? So again, use that same tool. I'm gonna choose an edge like this one right here. And notice if I go one direction or another, I can go fillet or chamfer, your choice, right? So you can go a chamfer this way, and I'm gonna type in 0.050 to chamfer that edge. Again, I could select all those edges ahead of time if I wanted to, or I can go back to the chamfer later on and say, hey, I wanna add some more, right? So here's my edges. I'm just gonna go ahead and start adding edges to that chamfer. So we have one feature and we're controlling all of the chamfered holes at the same time, right? Of course, you could make a new feature for each one, but that would just be ugly and inefficient. So definitely want to go back and edit and add the chamfers, you know, all the edges, one feature. That way later on, if you said, hey, instead of a 50,000th chamfer, I wanted a 60,000th chamfer, you could easily just change that right here and all those edges will automatically be updated. So a couple nice little tricks as far as making your tree or your history looking pretty clean, right? So here's our history. We got the original sketch right over here. We revolve it around. We had another sketch on top. We extrude that through. We had a big fillet, a couple small fillets, and then chamfer those holes. So that's pretty much basically what it takes to build a part like this. It's pretty straightforward. It sometimes takes a little bit of time to just define what that original sketch is and making sure you got all the dimensions. Of course, we pulled this from a database as far as a standard size pipe flange. But whatever you're working on, of course, if you're just creating something freeform, you can use whatever dimensions you want. But that's basically the tools and techniques you're going to use to create something that looks a lot like this.